Namaskar, my dear students. Today in the dental materials section, we will be discussing elastomer impression materials. These are important materials for making impression for the crown and bridge especially. These come as a short note in the theory exam or maybe a part of the long note. They are often kept as a spotter in the practical exam of dental materials, and they may also be asked in the viva. So let's begin. Now first, what is an impression? We all know that a dental impression is the negative replica of the hard and the soft oral tissues. We pour them with the gypsum product and we get the positive replica, that is the cast model, or a single tooth, that is the dye. Now before going further, let us quickly revise the classification of the impression materials. The impression materials, according to the mechanical behavior, they can be non-elastic and elastic. Non-elastic are the rigid impression materials, or the inelastic impression materials, which are basically used for the edentulous, which have minimal or no undercuts. Okay, they can be the impression plaster, impression compound, waxes, zinc oxide eugenol, impression paste. In the elastic, these are the materials which are mainly used for edentulous and dentulous patients having the undercuts. In this, we have the aqueous hydrocolloids. These are the water-based materials. Second is the non-aqueous elastomers that we will be discussing in detail today. In the aqueous, we have agar, which is reversible hydrocolloid, alginate, which is the irreversible hydrocolloid. In the non-aqueous, we have basically three materials: polysulfide, silicones, and the polyether. Silicone can further be condensation silicone and the addition silicone. Non-aqueous elastomers. What does it mean? From the name itself, we can make out non-aqueous. That means they are not water-based, non-aqueous. Second, elastomers. Elasto because they are elastic in nature. Their mechanical behavior shows elasticity. And mers because they set by polymerization. So these are the non-aqueous elastomers. Now all the non-aqueous elastomers, they are available in 5 viscosity classes, or the 5 consistencies. These are, first is the light body or the syringe consistency. It is available in syringes or cartridges. Okay. Second is the medium or the regular body. It is also, we use special trays for making the impression with the medium body. Then we have heavy body or the tray consistency, very heavy body or the putty consistency. The heavy body and the putty, we can make the impression with these materials in the perforated stock tray. And over that, we can make impression with the light body also as a wash impression. Last is the monophase. You know, it is associated with shear thinning, which is also called as the pseudoplasticity. It can be used both in the syringes and as a tray material. Now, if we go back to the classification, these non-aqueous elastomers can be of 3 types as we discussed. They can be polysulfides, silicones, and the polyethers. And these silicones can be condensation silicone or the addition silicone. So first, let us discuss the polysulfides. Polysulfides, which are also called as the mercaptan or the thiocol. These were the first rubber-based impression materials which were introduced in dentistry. And they were introduced after the hydrocolloids because they were more flexible. They were more resistant to tearing as compared to the agar and the alginate. You know, the main component of polysulfide is the multifunctional mercaptan, that is the SH group or the polysulfide polymer. This is a linear polymer which contains pendant SH groups, as we can see in the picture also. These polysulfide impression materials, they are available as a two paste system. One is the base paste and one is the accelerator or the catalyst paste. We will discuss the composition now. Then second, it is available in 3 viscosities, the light body, medium body and the heavy body. Now the composition of the polysulfide impression material. In the base paste, we have the basic polymer, the polysulfide polymer, which is the multifunctional mercaptan. we just discussed, it is around 80 to 85%. This polymer is further polymerized and cross-linked to form the rubber. Then it has a filler, titanium dioxide or zinc sulfate, 16 to 18%, which gives the strength to the material. Plasticizer, dibutyl phthalate, it provides the viscosity to the material, the workable property is. Then it has small quantity of sulfur, which is 0.5%, and it helps to accelerate the reaction. It is the accelerator. Okay, coming to the accelerator or the catalyst paste, the main catalyst is the lead dioxide, which is 60 to 68%. It reacts with the thiol and it causes the setting, the polymerization to occur. It gives brown color to the material. It is one of the multiple choice question which is asked. Then again, it has a filler and a plasticizer similar to the base paste, which gives the strength and the viscosity respectively. Oleic acid or stearic acid, which acts as a retarder to control the rate of the setting reaction. Now, how to memorize this composition? Very easy, filler and plasticizer are present in the both, and the base will contain the basic polymer, which is the mercaptan, and the accelerator will contain the catalyst, or the catalyst paste will contain the catalyst, which is the lead dioxide. Now, if we talk about the chemistry and the setting reaction of the polysulfide, we know that the polysulfide has the terminal and the pendant SH groups. Okay, now in presence of lead dioxide acts as an oxidizing agent and it leads to the initiation of the polymerization. So what happens? The oxidation of the terminal SH groups. Okay, it leads to the chain lengthening. And the oxidation of the pendant SH groups, it leads to the cross-linking. And this reaction, it finally yields water as the byproduct. Okay, so this is what is happening in the polymerization of polysulfide impression material. Indications. If we talk about the indications, they were used everywhere when they were introduced. They were used in complete denture, they were used in removable partial denture impressions, then maxillofacial cases also, and crown and bridge also. Okay, because they had superior properties as compared to the agar and alginate. But because of its disadvantages and because silicon came, so these polysulfide lost their popularity. Now, the pros and cons of the polysulfide impression materials. First, if we talk about the advantages, it has lower cost if we compare with the silicones and the polyethers. Second, it has a long working time of 4 to 5 minutes, which is sufficient to load the impression and make the impression. It has high tear strength of around 4000 grams per centimeter square. It has high flexibility and excellent detail production. Okay, it has very good shelf life also, which is around 2 years. Okay, second is the disadvantages. First, very important, it has very poor dimensional stability. We know that we saw in the reaction also that water is released as a byproduct. The curing shrinkage is very high, as it is 0.45%, and it has the highest permanent deformation also, which is around 3.5%. So it should be poured within an hour only. And a single pore can only be obtained. We cannot make multiple casts from a single impression. Then we need custom trays to make the impression with polysulfide. They are messy when we mix the two pastes. They give a bad odor also, and they may stain the clothing also. Okay, so proper drape should be there. It has a long setting time of 8 to 12 minutes. Again, it creates a problem for the patient to retain the impression for such a long time. The second materials in the non-aqueous elastomers are the silicones. Silicones, based on the polymerization reaction, they can make condensation and addition silicon. So first we'll be discussing the condensation silicones. Condensation silicon, right from the name condensation, because it sets by the condensation polymerization silicon, but is because it is a silicon based elastomer. Okay, the basic component of the condensation silicon is hydroxyl terminated polydimethyl siloxane. We can see the formula in the picture. It is available in two viscosities, putty and the light body. The putty is available in a jar. It's like a dough-like consistency. Light body is available in a tube. There is another tube which contains the catalyst. And this catalyst is mixed with either the putty or the light body as we need it. Indications, if we talk about, they are mainly used in complete denture and crown and bridge impressions. Trade names, yes, it is available by the name of Speedex or Primasil. Coming to the composition of the condensation silicon, it has two parts, base and the catalyst or the reactor. The base can be in the form of paste or in the putty form as we discussed. This mainly contains the basic polymer, which is hydroxyl terminated polydimethyl siloxane. It only undergoes the cross-linking and it forms the rubber. Second, it contains the filler, which is colloidal silica. Coming to the reactor or the catalyst, first, it has the cross-linking agent, which is the tetraethyl orthosilicate. And second, it has the catalyst, which is stannous octate. This is one of the multiple choice questions which is asked, catalyst in condensation silicon. Now let us understand the setting reaction of the condensation silicon. We see this is the basic polymer, that is hydroxy terminated polydimethyl siloxane. Okay, this is the basic polymer. In the presence of a cross-linking agent, this is the cross-linking agent, which is tetraethyl orthosilicate or the alkyl silicate. This is the cross-linking agent. What is happening in the presence of this agent? That the terminal hydroxyl groups, okay, these are the terminal hydroxyl groups, they will form a three-dimensional network. Here they are forming a three-dimensional network. Okay, and what is being released? The ethyl alcohol. Here the ethyl alcohol is released as the byproduct. Okay, and this evaporation of this ethyl alcohol is responsible for the condensation which is taking place in the set silicon impression. Okay, and in the whole process, the stannous octate, it acts as a catalyst. Now the pros and the cons of the condensation silicon. First, if we talk about the advantages, it has better elastic properties as compared to the polysulfides. Then it is clean, it is pleasant, no odor is present. So it is compliant for the patient. Then stock tray can be used for making the impression with the help of the putty wash technique. It has good working and setting time. The setting time is around 6 to 8 minutes and the mixing time is around 45 seconds. Then coming to the disadvantages, very, very important, it has poor dimensional stability because of the high curing shrinkage, which is around 0.4 to 0.6%. Okay, this shrinkage is occurring due to the polymerization and the evaporation of the byproduct, which is ethyl alcohol. Now, this is another multiple choice question which is asked, the byproduct of the condensation silicon. So that is why to avoid this, we should pour the impression immediately within 30 minutes. Okay, second, it is hydrophobic, it has poor wettability. So whenever we are making the impression, we should make the impression feel dry. Okay, the polysulfides were also hydrophobic. All the three elastomers except the polyethers are hydrophobic and they don't have good wettability. They can be electroplated. This is another advantage of the silicones, that they can be electroplated with silver or copper. Now, after the condensation silicon, the next material is the addition silicon impression material, which is a very important and very common material which is used for crown and bridge and FBD work. Addition silicon, as I told you, it is a very important elastomeric impression material, most common elastomer which is used in the clinics. The basic component of addition silicon is vinyl polysiloxane. Now, what was present in the condensation silicon was polydimethyl siloxane, and here we have vinyl polysiloxane. Another multiple choice question. Indications, yes, the addition silicon is a very important material for crown and bridge work. Second, in the complete denture, it can be used to do the border molding and making the final impressions also. Then it is also used as a bite registration material. Coming to the trade names, yes, it is available in many trade names, Express, Aquaseal, and many more. Composition of the addition silicones. In this, we have first we have the base paste. The main ingredient is polymethyl hydrogen siloxane. It is a low molecular weight silicon prepolymer with a silane terminal group. This is important, silane terminal group. It takes part in the polymerization reaction. Second, it has fillers, powdered silica. It acts as a filler. It controls the viscosity of the material and it also modifies the physical properties of the material. Second is the catalyst or the accelerator paste. In this, the main ingredient is polydimethyl vinyl siloxane. Now, what is the difference between this siloxane? It is a prepolymer with vinyl terminal group. Here it was silane terminal group, and here we have the vinyl terminal groups. This is the main reactive agent and it takes part in the chemical reaction. Now, second is again the filler, powdered silica, which is added to increase the strength, to gives the body to the mixture, physical properties, and controls the viscosity. Second, very, very important is the chloroplatinic acid, the platinum salt, which acts as a catalyst. Then the low molecular weight liquid polymer, which acts as a retarder, it controls the working and the setting time. Then platinum and palladium, again a multiple choice question. It acts as a scavenger for the hydrogen gas which is released. We will discuss this in detail. Then we have the colored pigments which distinguish this from the base paste. You know, both the pastes are of different color. When we mix them, we get a homogeneous color. So this is the composition of addition silicon. Many multiple choice question comes from the name of the ingredients. Setting reaction of addition silicon, very, very important. As we saw in the composition, that there are two siloxane groups. One is the divinyl polymethyl siloxane and second is the polymethyl hydrogen siloxane. When these two combine in the presence of the catalyst, that is the platinum salt, what happens? The addition polymerization reaction starts. The hydrogen from here, from the polymethyl hydrogen siloxane, it moves to the vinyl groups of divinyl polymethyl siloxane. And it forms a three-dimensional network, which is polyvinyl siloxane after the setting. So now the addition polymerization has taken place. No reaction byproducts will develop. Second, very, very important thing, that sulfur compounds, they retard the setting of addition silicones. Now, the advantages and the disadvantages of addition silicon. First, if we talk about the advantages, they are highly accurate material. They give excellent reproduction of the surface details. High dimensional stability. In fact, they have the best dimensional stability amongst all the elastomers. It has low curing shrinkage of 0.17% and low permanent deformation of 0.05 to 0.3%. And because of this high dimensional stability, they can be poured up to 1 week. So we can send the impressions to the laboratory. We do not need to pour them. Then we can use stock tray as well as custom tray for making the impressions because they are available in all the consistencies. Then we can pour multiple casts from the same impression. This is one of the biggest advantage this material can offer. Then it is very easy to mix. The manipulation part is not a very cumbersome job. Then it has pleasant color and pleasant odor. It is a very patient compliant material. If we talk about the disadvantages, the first and the important is it's expensive, especially if we compare with the other materials of FPD that we may use condensation silicon or alginate. Second, the sulfur, it inhibits the setting as we saw in the setting reaction also. So when we are working with latex gloves or ferric and aluminium sulfate retraction solution, it can inhibit the setting. So what we can do, we can avoid the gloves, or if we have worked with the gloves or if we have applied this retraction solution, we can pumice the teeth before making the impression. Second is there may be a possible hydrogen gas released, which has been observed during setting. Okay, this appears as bubbles on the dye, as we can see in the picture also. So what we can do, now the manufacturers, they are adding palladium, as we saw in the composition also. Palladium has been added to the composition so that it can absorb the gas and there will be no such bubbles on the cast. Now, after the silicones, the next material is polyether elastomers. Polyether impression materials or the polyether elastomers, they were introduced in Germany in 1960. They are indicated in crown and bridge work, dental implants, bite registration material. Now, this is one of the multiple choice questions which is asked, that the best material for dental implants is polyether. Okay, now if we talk about the commercial names, they can be Impregum F or Pentamex. Composition of the polyether impression material. First, the base paste. It contains the polyether polymer. It is only cross-linked to form the rubber. Okay, then we have the colloidal silica as a filler and glycol ether or the phthalate as a plasticizer. Second, in the accelerator paste or in the reactor paste, we have the alkyl aromatic sulfonate, which initiates the cross-linking. So it is the cross-linking agent, another multiple choice question. Colloidal silica filler and the phthalate acts as a plasticizer. Now the setting reaction of the polyether impression material. Now this is the amine terminated pre-polymer, okay, the polyether. In the presence of the aromatic sulfonate, which is the cross-linking agent, what happens? The ring opening takes place. Okay, ring opening and the chain extension takes place and it forms the cross-linked polyether rubber. And you know, this cross-linking, it offsets some of the shrinkage which can occur. Okay, it is an exothermic reaction which is also affected by the temperature. Advantages and the disadvantages of the polyether impression material. First, if we talk about the advantages, it is a highly accurate material. It has very good dimensional stability because no byproduct is released, addition polymerization reaction is taking place, and there is less polymerization shrinkage. Then stock or dual arch trays can be used for making the impression with polyether. It gives good surface details. Now, it can be poured within a week. Okay, so pouring can be delayed. We can send the impression to the lab. Multiple casts can be retrieved from the same impression. Another one of the big advantage. It has good wettability. Amongst all the elastomers, this is the material which has the best wettability as compared to the silicones and the polysulfide. Then comes the disadvantages. It is expensive as compared to the other elastomers. It has short working time of around 2 minutes. Okay, then it is a rigid material. It has high stiffness. It is difficult to remove from the undercuts. So for this, there is a thinner agent which can be added to the polyether, that is octyl phthalate. Okay, this acts as a thinner. It reduces the stiffness and the viscosity of the material. Then it has somewhat a bitter taste, it has low tear strength, and it can also absorb water because it is towards the hydrophilic. Okay, so these are the advantages and disadvantages of polyether. Manipulation of the various elastomeric impression materials. First, the impression can be made either in the stock tray or the custom tray, depending on the technique and the material, the consistency that we are using. Second, tray adhesive is very important. Separate tray adhesives are available for different elastomers, which should be applied either on the stock trays or the custom trays that we are using. Second is the manipulation. Manipulation can be done either by the hand mixing. If it is a putty material, we will take the two doughs and mix them, or we can pour the two tubes on the glass slab and mix with a spatula. That is the hand mixing. Auto mixing can be done either in the gun. A cartridge is fit into the gun, mixing tip is applied, and then the material is dispensed. Or we can use electrical dispensing system also, which automatically mix and gives the material. Okay, now coming to the techniques, if we are using a custom tray, what we do, we apply the light body on the prepared tooth. Then we put the heavy body on the tray and then we insert the tray into the patient's mouth. We get the impression with the light body covering the prepared tooth and the heavy body the rest of the arch. Okay, now second is the putty wash impression, which we do in the stock tray. In this, what we do, we first make the impression with the putty and then we make a space for the light body. Okay, then we make a wash impression of light body in that putty impression. That is called as the putty wash impression. Now let us just summarize the handling properties of all the elastomers in one table. Okay, first if we talk about the working time of polysulfide is 5 to 7 minutes, condensation silicone it is 3 minutes, addition 2 to 4.5 and polyether 2.5. So the maximum working time is provided by the polysulfide. The setting time also being the largest for the polysulfide. So that is why it acts as a disadvantage for the polysulfide, which is around 8 to 12 minutes. It comes as a multiple choice question also. Okay. Second is the stability. Stability, polysulfide impression can be poured after 1 hour. Condensation silicone should be poured immediately. Addition silicone and polyether, they can be kept for around 1 week, or we can send the impression to the lab directly. Then comes the wettability and the castability is fair for polysulfide, condensation silicone and addition silicone. Three of them, it is fair. The best wettability is provided by the polyether. Another multiple choice question. Now comes the cost. The cost of addition silicone and polyether are high as compared to the polysulfide and the condensation silicone. Now here we have compared the mechanical properties of all the four elastomers in one table. First is the elastic recovery. If we see, it is the maximum for the addition silicone, that is 99.9%. These have the best elastic recovery. Second is the flexibility. Polysulfide have the maximum flexibility. They are the most flexible amongst all the elastomers. This is one of the multiple choice question which is asked. Polyether have the least flexibility. They are the most rigid elastomer impression materials. They are used for dental implants. Very important multiple choice question. Flow, if we talk about, it is more for the polysulfide. Shrinkage, 24 hours. It is least for the addition silicone and then for the polyethers. Okay, because the addition polymerization is occurring and polysulfide have the most of the shrinkage, that is due to the reaction byproduct which is released in the polysulfide and also in the condensation silicone. Now coming to the tear strength, we can see compare that the tear strength of addition silicone is maximum amongst all the elastomers. Now let us compare some of the properties of the elastomers. You know, this comparison is very, very important. It helps you to solve the multiple choice question and it also helps to answer the viva questions quickly. So first is the working time. From the longest to the shortest, the polysulfides, they have the longest working time. Okay, and the polyether have the shortest working time. Second is the setting time, shortest to the longest. Here also the polyether, they have the shortest setting time and the polysulfides, they have the longest setting time. Now they are in correspondence. Okay. Third is the cost, from the lowest to the highest. If we compare hydrocolloids with them, the hydrocolloids have lower cost as compared to the elastomers. Now the polyether and the addition silicone, they are expensive materials as compared to the other elastomers. Now in continuation with the comparison of the properties, the next property is the dimensional stability. Best to the worst, the best dimensional stability is shown by the addition silicone amongst all the elastomers. And the worst is shown by the condensation silicone. The reason we know, because it sets by the condensation polymerization and the byproduct is being released. So the shrinkage is maximum. Then comes the wettability. wettability best to the worst. Now here if we compare the hydrocolloids, obviously the hydrocolloids will have the best wettability because they are hydrophilic material, they are water based materials. Amongst the elastomer, the polyether shows the best wettability. This is one of the multiple choice question which is asked. After polyether, hydrophilic addition silicon, then polysulfide, and then hydrophobic addition silicon and condensation silicon. Now the sequence of wettability is also asked in one of the multiple choice question. So that's all for today, my dear students, for this topic. I'm sure this video will help you to prepare this topic. Do not forget to share and like the video, and you can give your topics in the comment section. I will try to cover them soon. Please subscribe if you have not subscribed yet. Wish you success today and always.